In this video, I'll show you how to create a formula calculating your next invoice payment, a project status overview for your clients or team, and a full-on time tracker that updates relative to the minutes, hours, and days. This video is the last part of my Notion Formula 2.0 series. In part 1, we covered all the changes and 6 new important formula functions. In part 2, we started playing around with dates and the new if statement. And in this part 3, we're going to get into some more advanced formulas. Both part 1 and 2, which I'd recommend watching before this video, will be linked in the description below, as well as this freelancer dashboard that I'll be using in this video. And with that out of the way, let's get started. This first formula is inside our invoices page and is for calculating how much and when you'll receive your next payment from your client, with the date being updated automatically. This could also work for a subscription tracker or if you want to keep track of your employee's payroll. For this setup, we have a status property, the amount due, and the project start date. Inside our formula, we are going to start with the let's function and create one variable called date. Here we are going to introduce a new function called parseDate, which allows us to create our own date, but we have to type it in this exact format with a hyphen in between the numbers. We're going to use this for constructing our current date. So first we're going to add the now function followed by the year to get our current year, add a hyphen, and then do the exact same for the month. And then for the day, we're going to use the project date property, add a date start function, and format it to only give us the day. So now we've created a new date which uses our current year, our current month, and the day of our project date property. With our variable set, we can now start building out our formula. The first thing we're going to add is an if statement saying that if the status is set to open, then show everything that we're about to create. Otherwise, show nothing, which is indicated by these two quotation marks. The first part of our formula is going to be the dollar amount. So let's add the dollar symbol inside of quotation marks, followed by a plus, and the amount property with a format function to turn the number into a text value. Then we can add another plus, and then inside of quotation marks add text that says due on. And if you click done, the first part of your formula should be working correctly. Now for the next section, we're going to add another if statement saying that if now, which is our current date and time, is greater than the date, which is the variable that we set earlier, then show the date plus 1 month, which is set through this date add function specifying 1 month. Otherwise, just show the date. And then once this is added, just make sure to close off both if statements. Now let's test our formula. If we started the project on the 13th of October, it will show the next payment is due on the 13th of November. But if our project started 3 months ago, then it will still show that the next payment is due on the 13th of November. And when we get to the 13th of November, when it's the next payment, it will automatically update then to the 13th of December. So basically it just automatically adds 1 month relative to the current month. Now moving on to a more complex formula, but one of my personal favorites, which is this one showing an overview of the status of your projects for a specific client. Note that this can also work for teams to see the status of the projects that everyone is busy with. Alright, so here we have a projects database grouped to a client, and then we have a second view where we change the source of the database to our CRM. So we have one view with our projects database and one view with our clients database. Now go ahead and add a new formula to your clients database, and then make sure to only show that formula on the database view and to go into the layout tab and toggle on wrap all columns. Inside the formula, we're going to start off with the let's function to set our 4 variables. The first one is going to be called not started and will be our projects filtered to where the status of the projects is not started. And then we basically just repeat this for all the other statuses. So I got one for not started, in progress, client review, and completed projects. Once that's done, we can start with our first section, which is for the not started projects. Inside of quotation marks, let's add a red dot emoji and then text saying not started, followed by a colon and a space. Then we're going to add a plus, inside of quotation marks, add an open bracket and then another plus. Now we need to get the number of not started tasks. So to do this, we're just going to use the not started variable and add a length function next to it. Then we're going to add a plus and then inside of quotation marks, add a divider and then another plus. Now we need the number of total projects. So we're simply going to select our projects relation property and also add a length function next to it. And then we're going to close everything off by adding a plus and then a closing bracket inside of quotation marks. And then the last thing we need to do is make everything red. So we're going to put this whole formula inside of brackets and then at the end add a style function and make everything bold and red. Now after adding in the text, we need to make the project show up underneath. So to do this, we're first going to add a line break with backslash n. And then we're going to introduce a new function that works similar to the line breaks, which is backslash t and is for adding tabs to your formula. With these in place, we can now add our projects by clicking our not started variable and then adding a sort function so they're in alphabetical order. Now you'll see that if we leave it like this, then the projects are underneath and tab to the right, but the individual projects aren't underneath each other. So to fix this, we're going to add another new function called join. Inside of join, we're going to specify how we want the projects to join together. So since we want all of them underneath each other and tab to the right, we're just going to add a line break and a tab inside the join brackets. Simply add your emoji or symbol after the first tab function and then also after the tab inside of the join function. You can obviously play around and add anything you want, but I'm just going to keep it simple and use this dot symbol I found on getsymbols.com. Once this is done, we want to add two line breaks and then just rinse and repeat this for each of the statuses. Simply copy and paste everything and just change the text, the color and the variables. I'm also adding comments to each section just to keep everything clean and organized. And then when you get to the last project status, just make sure you remove one of the line breaks at the end. If you followed each step correctly, you now should have a working overview of your client or team's projects where you can actually click on the project page and open it. Our next formula is for time tracking. When we create a new task and use the default task template button, it will automatically add an icon as well as this time tracker database, which I'll show you how to build in just a second, and two time tracking buttons, one to start and one to end the time tracking. So when you start working on a task, you can click the start log button, and in the time tracker database, you'll see we have a new database entry with a start date. And then once we've stopped working on the task, we can click the end log button to add in the end date to the time tracker. And then on the main calendar, we have the formula that we'll be creating where you'll see how many minutes, hours or days has elapsed since working on this task. Before we can tackle the formula, we first need to set up a time tracking database. So let's quickly run through that process. Simply create a new table database and add the following properties: a date property called start date, a date property called end date, a checkbox property called active log, a person property if you're working as a team, and a relation property to your task database. Then we're going to add four small formulas. The first one is called minutes elapsed, which will be the minutes between the end and start date specified by the minutes inside of quotation marks inside the date between function. The next one is the total hours elapsed and is the exact same, except you change minutes to hours. And then the same goes for the third one, where it's the total days. And then our last formula is if you're working together with a team to see who's actively working on the task. For this one, we're simply going to create an if statement that says if the active log checkbox is checked, then show the person property, otherwise show nothing. And as you can see, when we check the active log checkbox, it'll now show who's working on that task. Once our time tracker database is set up, it's time to add it to our template button. So let's go back to our dashboard and copy the database link and then go into our task template button, which you can find by clicking the drop down next to new, and then pasting our database as a linked view inside of the template button. And then just hide all of your properties except the name, active log checkbox, and the two date properties. Now what we're going to do is add a self-referencing relation so that when you create a new database entry on this time tracker, it will automatically be related to the current task that you're in. So to do this, all you want to do is just simply filter this database relation to the current template button. And next up is our two buttons, which you can create by simply typing in /button. For the first button, we're going to select the add page to option and connect it to our time tracker database. And as for the properties, we want to have the active log checkbox check. We want the start date to use the dynamic now option. For the person property, we also want to select the dynamic option for the person who clicks this button. And then for our task relation, we want to select this page. Let's name our button to start log and give it a green start icon. And now for our end log button, we're going to create a new button and this time select the edit pages option and then choose our time tracker database. Now let's add a filter so we only edit pages where the active log checkbox property is checked and if the person property is ourselves. Then the properties we want to edit is going to be the end date, where we'll choose the dynamic now option and then also uncheck the active log checkbox. After this, we can give our button a name and also give it a red stop icon. And then let's just drag these buttons next to each other. Before we continue, let's just make sure everything is working correctly by adding a new task using this template button. As you can see, both our buttons and our time tracker database loaded. And if we click on start log, it will start tracking the time and the end log button will end the time tracking. And if you're working together as a team, then on your task database, you want to add a rollup property that is connected to your time tracker database that shows the who's working on it property. That way you can have a database view on your dashboard showing who in your team is working on what and how long they're taking per task. And if you want to see how long each project is taking, then you need to create a formula called total time tracked on your task database. Inside this formula, you want to use the map function, select the time tracker database, and then use the current function to select the hours elapsed property with with a sum function at the end. Then you need to go into your project's database and add a formula called total time track. Inside this formula, you want to again use the map function, this time selecting your task database, and then with the current function, select the total time tracked formula that you just created. And then you also want to add a sum function at the end, followed by a plus and an H inside of quotation marks for the hours. And there you go. You now have a fully functional time tracker. However, we're going to take it a step further and create a formula that will show the total minutes, hours, or days, depending on how long it took, and then changing the color when the task is marked as complete. So let's go ahead and jump into our task database and create a new formula called time track. Inside our formula, we're going to start with the let's function to set three variables that we'll use throughout the formula. The first one we're going to call minutes, and this is going to be a map function to select our related time tracker database, followed by a current function so we can use our minutes elapsed formula, and then we're also going to add a sum function at the end. We're going to repeat this for the other two variables as well, which will be for the hours and the days. Once our variables are set, we're going to close off this let's function with a comma and then start our formula. We're going to start off with an if function and open up the brackets. For our if function, we're going to say if the done checkbox property is not checked, aka if the task is not done, then show everything that we're about to create. For this first section, we're going to use the new ifs function, which I already covered in depth in part 2, so be sure to check that video out. Now just bear with me, this next part might get repetitive. For this ifs function, we're going to say if the minutes is 0, then show nothing, indicated by two quotation marks. Otherwise, if the minutes is 1, then show the total minutes with text saying minute elapsed. Otherwise, if the minutes is less than 60, then show the total minutes with text saying minutes elapsed. Otherwise, if the hours is 1, then show the total hours with text saying hour elapsed. Otherwise, if the hours is equal to or less than 24, then show the total hours with text saying hours elapsed. Otherwise, if the days is more than 1, then show the total days with text saying days elapsed. Otherwise, if the days is 1, then show the total days with text saying day elapsed. Otherwise, show nothing. The reason for all of this is if it's 1 minute, 1 hour, or 1 day, we don't want the text to say days plural, we just wanted to say day singular. Now that we've got the first part of our if statement, we want to add a comma and then copy and paste everything that we've just created. Then just make sure you have the correct amount of closing brackets and your formula should be working. So basically what we did is this first part is for when the task is incomplete, and then the second part is for when the task is marked as complete. And at the moment it's the exact same formula, but we're going to just style both of them differently. So let's go ahead and do that right now. I'll also quickly be adding in comments to each section of the formula using the forward slash and asterisk just to keep everything nice and organized. In our uncompleted section, we only want to style the text. So we're going to add a style function next to the text and specify that we want to make it bold with a letter B and make it red by typing in the color name. And then we're just going to copy and paste the styling onto each piece of text for this uncompleted section. Now for the completed section, I want to make everything bold and green. So for this one, I'm going to add everything inside of brackets and then add a style function at the end, making it bold and green. Now if you click on done and mark our task as complete, you'll see our formula color changing. And now for the finishing touch, we're going to add a checkbox emoji inside of quotation marks followed by a plus to the start of our completed section. So if we click on done, our checkbox emoji will now be added and our time tracking formula is done. The reason I styled it this way is simply just to show you there are multiple ways to style your formulas, but you can obviously play around and style it any which way you like. If you want to save yourself time creating all of this yourself, then be sure to grab the freelancer dashboard through the first link in the description, and also make sure to watch part 1 and part 2 if you haven't already. I hope this Formula 2.0 series was useful. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.